Hello my dear students, welcome to our channel Chemistry Physics, where physics gets charged. In the last video we discussed the concept of distance and displacement and its various applications. So now in the today's video we'll discuss the concept of speed and next velocity. So basically the speed can be defined as the distance traveled by the body per unit time. The distance may be of rectilinear or curvilinear, so that as the distance is a scalar quantity, so speed is also a scalar quantity. Speed is a scalar quantity. Okay, so and when you are coming to the SI units of this, SI units are meter per second, and coming to the CGS units, you can write a centimeter per second. Centimeter per second are the CGS units and meter per second are the SI units. Okay, and in the practical, in the problems we are using, the other units of this speeds are kilometer per hour, KMPH. Kilometer per hour. So, but even though in the problems they are given the units of kilometer per hour of the speed, but in the answers means finally you should be right that units of that speed in terms of meter per second. Means you have to know the conversion of this kilometer per hour to meter per second. So for that, 1 km/h, kilometer per hour. So 1 km is equal to, what do you know? 1000 m per hour. Hour is equals to 60 minutes into 60 seconds, means 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. So this is what you will get, a 5 is 3 is 6 3 is, means 1 km/h is equals to 5/18 m/s. Means wherever in the problems we have the kilometer per hour, now to converting it into meter per second, you have to multiplying it with the 5/18. For understanding purpose, I give an example. If the body moves with 72 km/h is given, when you want to write this speed in terms of meter per second, simply you should write instead of kilometer per hour, 5/18 m/s. So that 18 ones are 18 fours are 4 fives are 20 m/s. This is the way we are converting a kilometer per hour into meter per second. This is not very useful in solving problems. This is what speed. The speed is what? The ratio of distance covered per unit time. The distance may be of rectilinear or curvilinear. Okay, sir. So when it is a rectilinear or curvilinear, as it is a scalar quantity, the speed is also a scalar quantity. Why? Because it does not have any specific direction, right? So now when I'm coming to the average speed, this average speed can be defined as the total distance traveled by a body, total interval of time taken, or the journey time for its motion is called average speed. Just to understand this, let the body is moves along a straight line from A to B. Let it covering a distance of S1 in a time interval T1, in a S2 in a time interval T2, and S3 in a time interval T3. So means it covers the different distances in different intervals of time, so that the average speed can be defined as the total distance traveled is nothing but S1 plus S2 plus S3 upon total time taken is a T1 plus T2 plus T3. Then what is the necessity of defining this average speed, sir? So basically the motion is of two types, is a uniform motion and non-uniform motion. The uniform motion is nothing but if body covers equal distances in equal intervals of time, however maybe the intervals may be small, then that kind of motion is called uniform motion. If the body covers unequal distances in a regular intervals of time, then it is said to be non-uniform motion. So based on this uniform and non-uniform motion, we have the uniform speed and non-uniform speed. Means uniform speed means at every instant if the body moving the same speed, then it covers the same distances in same intervals of time, then it is said to be uniform speed. When it is a non-uniform speed means it moving with the different speeds, like a 20 m/s, 30 m/s, 40 m/s. Then when that speed is changes, the distance covers are changes. When the distance covers are changes, then we need to define this average speed. Got the importance of average speed? So the average speed can be defined as the total distance traveled by total time taken is said to be average speed. So now we can write this average speed in different forms. Like the first form is body covers different distances, cover different distances with different speeds, means according to this statement, this is an important one, problematic purpose. So here the time intervals are not mentioned. Means according to this statement, when I am coming to draw the diagram, let again it is the initial point, here it is the final point. So let the distance of S1 is covering with the speed V1, and of distance S2 is covering with the speed V2, and last distance of S3 is covering with the speed of V3. Then our intention is to find what is the average speed during its entire journey right from A to B here. That is what this special case is, cover the different distances with the different speeds. So average speed is the total distance covered S1 plus S2 plus S3 by total time taken is the actual expression for average speed. But according to this case, here time intervals are not given. Even though they are not given, definitely they will take certain time intervals of T1, T2, T3, but is not given in this case. So we have to replace this T in terms of S and V so that we will get the average speed in terms of distance and speed. That is what the important case here. So for that, we know basically speed is equals to distance by time. This implies time is equals to, we can write distance by speed here. Okay, so by using this basic equation, we can write now the average speed in terms of distance and speed as S1 plus S2 plus S3 upon, so T1 can be written as S1 by V1, T2 is the S2 by V2, plus T3 is the S3 by V3. Means now again we will get the expression for average speed, but now this average speed is in terms of speed and distance. Got my point? So now again in this, sir, if they are given the body covers equal distances in unequal intervals of time, equal distances in unequal intervals of time means again the body is moving with a varying speed only. In such case, how we could find the average speed? Understood? So now body covers, if body covers equal distances with a different speeds, with a different speeds here. Okay, students. So now the meaning of this is, here S1 is equals to S2 is equals to S3. Say the distance is S, not only of 3, you may take any intervals of distances, please. For our convenience, I am taking 3. If the 4s are there, sir, S4 plus S4 by V4. Here also, S3, S4 plus T4, S5 plus T5, and so on, right? So I am coming to this point now. As the distances are same, so but different speeds means according to this, now we can write S, 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 but off with the speeds V1, V2, and V3 is the meaning of this statement here, is the important one again. Okay, so now here we can write the average speed is equals to, you can write as S plus S plus S by S by V1 plus S by V2 plus S by V3. So this is equals to 3S upon, by taking S common in the denominator, so we will get here 1 by V1 plus 1 by V2 plus 1 by V3 is equals to V average. Okay, so now this S, S will get cancelled. So by using this, can I write a 3 by V average is equals to 1 by V1 plus 1 by V2 plus 1 by V3 is the average speed. By using this, we can say that when the distances are equal, the average speed is the harmonic mean of individual speeds. The harmonic mean of individual speeds. Sir, I want to write average speed only, sir. Okay, no problem. To write that average speed, here the LCM is V1, V2, V3. So we can write here V1, V2 plus V2, V3 plus V3, V1. Actually, it is a V2, V3, it is a V1, V3, it is a V1, V2. I am writing in cyclic. Okay, so is equals to 3 by V average here. Therefore, you required V average only. So V average is equals to, you may write 3 V1, V2, V3 upon V1, V2 plus V2, V3 plus V3, V1 is the expression for average speed when the three equal distances are covered. Either by using this equation, you may find the average speed, or also by using this equation, you can find the average speed. Here, by this, you can say that the harmonic mean of individual speeds is gives the average speed when the distances, the covered distances are same but different speeds here. For two equal distances, for two equal distances, according to this, the same thing, just we have this much only. When you have this much only, then it will become 2s. So, can I write simply 2 by v average is equals to 1 by v1 plus 1 by v2. That's it. And by this, here we can write 2 by v average is equals to, the LCM is v1, v2. Here it is of v2 plus v1. Therefore, in the case of two equal distances, we can write v average as 2v1 v2 by v1 plus v2 here. This is what the average speed when the two equal distances covering with the different speeds. So, this is the first case, a covering at different distances with the different speeds. In that special case, equal distances with the different speeds. Now, I am coming to another case where it covering in different intervals of time, covering with the different speeds here. Now, the case is the body moving with the different speeds in a different intervals of time between A and B. Even though the distances are not given, definitely it covers the distance of S1, S2, S3, so that I can write the basic equation for average speed as S1 plus S2 plus S3 is the total distance covered, but the total time taken is the T1 plus T2 plus T3. But as the S1, S2, S3 are not given, we have to write this S in terms of V and T. Again, from basic equation of V is equals to S by T, so this implies we can write S is equals to V into T. By using this, here we can write the average speed is equals to, instead of S1, can I write V1 T1 plus S2 is a V2 T2 plus S3 is a V3 T3 upon T1 plus T2 plus T3 is the expression for average speed in terms of speed and time. At first, average speed in terms of distance and time is S1 plus S2 plus S3 by T1 plus T2 plus T3. In terms of distance and speed is the S1 plus S2 plus S3 upon S1 by V1 plus S2 by V2 plus S3 by V3. These are the three different forms of average speed here, right? So, now again, if it moves with different speeds in equal intervals of time, which means in this case, again, the meaning of this case is T1 is equals to T2, this is equals to T3, say the time is T. By using this here, now you can write V average is equals to V1 T plus V2 T plus V3 T upon T plus T plus T. So, by using this here, V1 plus V2 plus V3, taking T outside, upon T plus T plus T is a 3T. So, therefore, we can write the average speed as V1 plus V2 plus V3 upon 3. If the four equal intervals of time, then V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4 by 4, like N. V1 plus V2 plus up so on Vn by N, which means when the time intervals are equal and moving the different speeds, it is the arithmetic mean of individual speeds. When the distances are equal, then there is a harmonic mean of individual speeds. These are the some important special cases of average speeds. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, do like, share, comment and subscribe our channel to get more videos.